Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. If you're considering getting the new Mac Pro, but the price tag is a little high, here are some alternatives. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So there's no doubt about it, the new Mac Pro is a great machine. But the price tag is a little high for individual users. But if you want a pro-level Mac, Apple has several alternatives for you that cost less. You just have to go above the baseline specifications for some of these models. So here's the new Mac Pro, the base model. You get 3.5 GHz, 8-core Intel Xeon W processor. You have a 580X GPU with 8 gigs of memory. You have 32 gigs of regular memory. It only comes with a 256 gigabyte SSD. But we're going to stick with this base model. Just use $6,000 as our base price. Now let's compare that with Apple's other Pro desktop, the iMac Pro. The iMac Pro design is a little old, but probably not due for an update anytime soon. It comes with a slightly slower processor, 3.2 GHz, 8 core. You get a different type of GPU. You get the Radeon Pro Vega 56, but it has 8 gigs of memory as well. The base model comes with 32 gigs of memory, just like the Mac Pro, but the base model for the iMac Pro comes with a 1 TB SSD. So you actually get a bonus. And for this, you're paying $1,000 less. So maybe not as good of a processor or a GPU, but a bigger hard drive. And of course, you get a bonus with the iMac Pro, the nice big 5K screen. But you don't have to get the iMac Pro. You can get a regular iMac and add some things to it to get it pretty close. So here's the current 27-inch iMac. And with the base model, you get a 3 GHz 6-core i5. The GPU is the Radeon Pro 570X and it only has 4 gigs of RAM. You get only a base 8 gigs of memory and you get a 1 TB drive, but it's a fusion drive, so a combination hard drive SSD. Now for this you pay a low price of $1,799. If you want to get this closer to the Pro, you want to pay extra $900, which will get you up to a 3.6 GHz 8-core i9. This same $900 also adds a 580X with 8 GHz, so the same basic GPU as what you get on the Mac Pro. If you want to boost the memory to 32 gigs, you're going to pay $600 more. And if you want to go to an SSD, you have to go and add $100 and you get the 512 gigabyte SSD, which is actually twice the size of what you get on a Mac Pro. So you come pretty close to an iMac Pro and even a Mac Pro, but you're only paying $3,400 for it. Now one thing to consider is getting the previous generation of Mac Pro. This is what I've got. And I'm sure you're still going to be able to find these for a while. If Apple doesn't sell them new, they're going to sell them refurbished and some resellers may have them, and also you can grab one used. So if you can still order one custom from Apple, then the base model is a 3.5 GHz 6-core and you get a FirePro D500, which is a much older card, but you get two of them. 16 gigs of memory is what comes standard and you get a 256 gigabyte drive, so the same as now. And for that you only pay $3,000, although refurbished might be less, resellers may be less, or they may become more as demand may increase for this model. Now if you boost it up to an 8-core Xeon E5 and then you go with the faster D700 with 6 gigs of RAM, you're still not quite up there in terms of the processor and GPU, but you're closer. Then you add 32 gigs of RAM, a little bit older and slower RAM, and you stick with that same drive, then the base price goes to $4,400, or it may vary depending upon what you can find. Well, there's one more Pro model that Apple sells, of course, that's the MacBook Pro. And if you want to take a look at the new 16-inch MacBook Pro and think of that as an alternative to getting a Mac Pro, here's what you end up with. So the base model is only a 2.6 GHz 6-core i7. It comes with a 5300M, that's M for mobile, GPU with only 4 gigs of memory, 16 gigs of RAM base, but you do get a bigger hard drive, a 512 gig SSD, and for that you're only paying $2,400. Now, you take that closer to a Mac Pro, the best you can do is a 2.4 GHz 8-core i9. Then you can get the 5500M GPU with 8 gigs of memory. You go to 16 gigs of RAM, and by going to the 8-core i9 processor, you're going to get a 1 TB drive, so bonus drive space. And for that, you're going to pay $3,500. Not bad considering, of course, this model will also then be portable, has its own screen, and it's the newest Mac that's out there besides the Mac Pro itself. But there's one last contender, and that's the Mac Mini. It may surprise you how powerful a Mac Mini can get. So if you go with the base level Mac Mini, you don't get much. You get a 3.6 GHz quad-core i3. Much slower than the Mac Pro. A GPU, you get none. There's no GPU in it. Well, there's, you know, the integrated graphics GPU. So it's going to use regular memory for graphics. So you get that, which doesn't help you in a lot of cases, although some Apple software like Final Cut Pro is actually pretty optimized for this, so it's still usable. 8 gigs of RAM is what you get for the base and only 128 gigabyte SSD. So it doesn't sound good until you look at the price and see that it's only $800. Now if you want to bring this closer to a Pro, you can go all the way up to a 3.2 gigahertz 6-core i7. Still not that great compared to the Mac Pro, but better. Then you have to go with an external GPU, and it's not as bad as it sounds because you can get a $400 external GPU that allow you to hook up 3 screens and actually be pretty decent. Then you can go with 32 gigs of RAM, of course, and boost the drive to be the same as the Mac Pro. And for this, you're only paying $2,300, which is quite a bargain considering a lot of people in the market for a Mac Pro actually could do pretty well with that machine. Now there are a lot of other things to consider besides what I just showed you. You have to look at the number and type of ports that are on each Mac. They're going to be different than a Mac Pro. And also the number of displays that can be supported by each of these is going to be a little bit different. If you want to keep your current display, then getting an iMac or an iMac Pro or a MacBook Pro probably isn't the right choice for you. The new Mac Pro is extremely expandable with all these slots and everything like that. Other Macs, you're going to have to add external peripherals to it. Future proofing is a big deal, especially if you're looking at getting, say, the old Mac Pro, which is 2013. So you can expect that it probably will run the next version of macOS, but maybe not past that. Whereas one of the newer models is going to be running versions of macOS 5 to 8 years into the future. And also, of course, you're going to want to look probably at better specs than what I just showed. This was comparing the base level Mac Pro. In particular, that 256 gig SSD was probably a little light. So you're probably going to want to compare prices with a 1 terabyte SSD. So here's a wrap up. You can see the Mac Pro at the top end, $6,000, and then you go down from there. Yeah, $5,000 for an iMac Pro, which is pretty good. Plus you get the screen and a bigger drive. You've got a regular iMac at $3,400. Same thing with the screen and a slightly bigger drive. The older Mac Pro is a pretty good machine, but you have to consider that it only has Thunderbolt 2. And of course it's old, which means it may not be getting macOS updates for that much longer. A 16-inch MacBook Pro is a pretty good deal at $3,500, especially considering it has its own screen, of course, and it's portable. For some people, that makes it the only choice here. And then the Mac Mini is a great budget choice, giving you something that's borderline Pro level with an external GPU at only $2,300. So if you're in the market for a top level Mac, which one of these options are you considering? I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.